Good morning, Elasmer boys. Today we will do another number-based practical program, Circular Prime. This is also came in a year of IASC practical, and this is a complete number-based program. So this will be the second question that I'm doing in a video as number-based after Smith number. So let's see the question. As the question, you can see in the screen, it says that a circular prime is a prime number that remains prime under cyclic shift of its digit. When the leftmost digit is removed and replaced at the end of the remaining strings of digit, the generate number is still prime. Let's look at the example. 131 is a prime number. So whenever the first one is being picked up and placed at the end, 311 is becoming another prime number. Similarly, 3 has been picked up and put it at the end, 113 is another prime number. So no matter how many times you shift it, it will remain as a prime number. So let's do the program. And to do the program, I'm going to use the same way in the other previous Smith number program. I did the concept using different methods. So here also I'm going to use different methods to compute the whole thing. So I'm going to start with the class name as Circular Prime. Okay. And clear out the whole data. Starting with import java.util.star class circular prime. Here I'm taking two variables, one which will going to accept the value, okay. Another one is I'm taking one extra variable in case if it's required for anything. So I'm giving the name of the variable as shift, sorry. Now I'm writing the mean first. So I'm writing public static void mean, and I'm going to accept the number from the user. So I'm writing scanner sc equal to new scanner in the bracket system.in semicolon. Now I'm going to ask for the value. So system.out.println, enter the number. I'm going to take the number in a separate variable, or you can take ano, that's up to you, okay. So as I have taken the ano in the private mode, so let me use that private data member variable only. So I'm here using ano equal to sc dot next int, okay. And see in my output part, while giving the question, they're first printing the original number once. So what I'm doing is that I'm printing the original number once, okay. So to do that, I'm writing system.out.println and then the value, which is ano, okay. Now I have to count how many digits are there, because that many times cyclic shift is actually happening. See, it has three digits. So basic maximum three combination it can have. 11393 is a prime number which has four digit. So maximum four combination and alteration it can have. So I have to count how many digit is there. One combination I already have, 1193. I have to make another three more combination, okay. Same logic over here. One combination is done out of the three digit, I have to make another two more combination. So So this logic only I am going to apply over here. So to count a number of digit, I am taking it inside a copy variable, and then I'm going to count how many digit are there. So to count the digit, I'm using variable C. Okay. Now I am writing while copy not equal to 0, open curly brace, C++, then copy divided by equal to 10. Okay. Now after I know that these many digits are there, I have to do the shifting. So to do the shifting, how many times the shifting will occur? The shifting will occur if 3 digit 2 time, 4 digit 3 time. So I'm running a loop for int I equal to 1, I less than C, I plus plus, okay? And then whatever the shifting work, I will do it in a method. So I'm going to call that with, suppose the method name I'm giving as shifting, and pass first the original value that I have accepted from there. Okay. Now after shifting each time, each and every combination, look at the question. In each and every time, the combinations are printing in my code. So the same way I'm going to print every combination after getting the shifting value. So let's go back to the program. I'm writing system.out.println, and whatever the value after shifting I'm getting, I'm printing that. Now every shift value has to be a prime number. So what I'm thinking is that as well as the shifting, I will do in another method to check whether the number is a prime or not. That prime checking also I will do in some other method. So for that reason, what I am writing, if I'm assuming that I will use the name of the method as prime, so if prime with that shifting value is somewhere not matching, okay, so it is becoming false. So let me take a boolean variable over here. Let me take a boolean flag equal to true. Okay, now in case it becomes false, then I will make my flag value also false, and I will break from the loop. I will not do any more shifting checking. Okay. Now 113, see the example 131, first after the shift I will get 311. Now this particular 3 is needed to be shifted at the back, right? So the shifting value is now as if my current value. So to do that, I need to replace it with my original value. So my original value is in the NO variable. Now whatever I got after shifting, that will become now my current variable. Anywhere, if I don't find that the flag is false, it means the flag is always remains true no matter how many shifting we are doing. So I can write at the end system.out.println. It is a circular prime number, else system.out.println, it's not a circular prime number. Okay, I'm closing it. So see, you can see in the screen already that the main part is closed. Now I'm going to write two methods. One is the shifting method, another is the prime method, because these are the two methods that I have created over here. So let's start with the easier one, which we know already many times, which is the prime method. So what I am doing is that I am writing the prime method with a static, okay, method, so that I don't need to create object As you can see, I have not created any object also. I just call them with their caller function name. So that is why call function name. So that is why I'm just using as a static method of them. So I'm writing public static boolean, as it is going to check in true and false. So I will write boolean prime with same ano, you can check. Here I have to count how many factors it gives. So count equal to 0. Running the shortest for loop, so int j equal to 2, j less than equal to ano by 2, semicolon j plus plus. Now if the number mod j equal to equal to 0, then count plus plus. If my count remains same 0, because my loop is from 2 to ano by 2, so I am going to return true, otherwise I'm going to return false. Okay, now after this part I'm going to do the shifting. Now to do the number formation shifting, there is two way you can do it. We did the number formation format through the while loop. Another thing is that we know many string functions. Okay, so just to pick it up it as a first character and to place it at the end, I think string functions will work much more better. So number to string, this is a concept we're going to use. And then again, I have to check for the prime. So from string to number also, we will going to shift, move it. So how to do that? While doing it, first writing the, as in I'm going to return it within a string format, okay? So what I'm doing is that, where I have got the value of shifting, I am just going to write integer dot parse int. This method will going to convert the shifted new value into integer. Okay, so in this way I can keep my return type over here as string, public static string, and shifting. What I'm shifting the value int no, whatever they are passing me from the top function. So what I'm doing is that to get the shifting value, I'm taking a separate variable called result, which is blank. Now how to do in most easiest way to convert a number into string is just take a copy x, any variable name, start with double quote start on off, concatenate it with no space, null value, it means it remains the same. Now I'm going to use the function of substring to do the chopping of the value that I got. So to get the result, what I'm doing is that copy x dot, first I have to pick it up the second element onwards, okay, 1, 3, 1. So I'm picking 3 and 1. So 3 and 1, to pick that, it is starting from the character number 1. If I thought 1, 3, 1 that as a total string value, okay, so to do that, it will be substring. Substring, everything is in small. We'll start from 1 and rest of the all the numbers will follow up. Now I'm left out with my first digit. So you can use caret 0 also in this case. I'm using, keeping it same at substring only. I'm rewriting substring 0, 1. So 1 before 1 it will finish. So it will start with 0, it will end in 0 only. Okay, and then I'm returning the resultant variable, which is result, and I'm closing it. So till my main everything is being finished, let's see what are the errors I can get in the program. Okay, println. Okay, now compile. number non-static variable as in the form of a static point. Okay, so to do that, what I'm doing is that as I have not used this shift over there, so I'm deleting this requirement from here and I'm just making it as a int now. Okay, so this will be NO because my passed value is NO. Copy X. Okay, so no syntax error I'm getting. Now let me see whether the program is giving me correct input or output. Okay, I'm closing it. Circular prime, running the program. First I'm giving the number as 131. So it's showing me first 131, then 311, then 113. So all the combination and correctly all of the combination are prime number. So it is showing me correctly the prime number. Let's run, okay, two more numbers. 11, suppose 93. So combination 1193 is giving me correctly 1931. Then again shifting back 9311. Now 3119. So all the combinations are correct. So it is also a circular prime number. Now let's start with another circular prime number. Let's see 29. So 29 opposite is 92. 92 is not a circular prime number. So that is why it is giving me correct result with everything correctly. So I am successful of making the circular prime. Okay. I hope you can practice similar based of programs where you can use methods to make objective of the program much more balanced rather than writing completely as a whole, okay, within the main function. In this pandemic situation, as I keep on saying, keep use hand sanitizer, wear mask before going out if necessary. Otherwise, stay in lockdown, see the online videos, keep yourself updated. We will meet very soon. Okay, take care, boys. Thank you very much.